As engineers, we understand how modern software has expanded the horizons for what we're able to accomplish. From the old days of drafting boards and hand calculations, we now have advanced software that is capable of simulating and solving increasingly complex engineering problems. The problem is these great pieces of software are also very expensive, and for good reason, but there are a ton of great programs out there that can help us solve the same engineering problems without the price tag. And when I say without the price tag, I mean completely free. I'm not talking about student licenses or trials. These are completely free and open source to download. This is going to be a great video for engineers of all types, especially if you're a hobbyist, or a tinkerer, or an independent inventor. Maybe you're somebody who has a side project or a business you're trying to get off the ground, but you don't have a ton of money to invest in software. I'm going to be covering a lot of different programs in this one that could help you out with those projects. I'll go over what each program does, some of the commercial software they replace, and then I'll share some of my thoughts along the way. So with that, let's dive in. First up, we have everyone's favorite, statistics. We'll just get this one out of the way. The software I'll be covering here is R. R is a programming language and interface built for statistical computing and graphics. What does that mean? Well, it's good at stats, you know, everyone's least favorite subject in college. You can compare this to other programs like Minitab or SPSS, only this one's free. The stock program is command line based, but there are a lot of great plugins like R Commander or R Studio that give it a lot more user-friendly front-end interface. One of my favorite things about R is that it's open source, so there are a lot of great developers out there that have made packages for things like Six Sigma and quality control. By the way, sorry to you computer programmers out there. I realize R is a programming language and I'm talking about it like it's a statistical package, so keep that in mind. R is at its core a programming language. It's a great language to learn if you want to get into things like data analytics and even machine learning or IIoT. It's very scalable and powerful, and many top companies use this language either in their business or software. Facebook's data analytics team actually uses this software to analyze data and create custom visualizations. Most engineers learn about a program called MATLAB in college. It is one of the most common mathematical modeling and computing programs out there. One of the best free alternatives I could find is a program called SciLab. SciLab is open source and developed for mathematical computing for engineering and science applications. It has a wide variety of mathematical functions and graphing capabilities. With it, we are able to create mathematical models for mechanical, electrical, fluid, and data analysis applications. When you download SciLab, you also get the XCOS module, which is great for modeling dynamic systems and controls for mechanical, electrical, and hydraulic systems. I admit these types of programs are far outside of my area of expertise, so I don't have a ton of input to offer. But from the built-in open source demonstrations, it really seems like this program is capable of a lot. It even has a MATLAB to SciLab translator that supposedly can convert MATLAB projects. All right, I think that's enough for the heavy mathematical programs. Let's move on to the more fun and interesting pieces of software on the list. So stick with me, things are about to get even more interesting. 2D CAD is a cornerstone for most engineering disciplines. Although things have been making a heavy shift toward 3D modeling and parametrics, 2D is still heavily used in industry today. DraftSight is a great free 2D CAD package that was developed by Dassault Systems, the creator of SolidWorks, which is a very popular 3D CAD program. DraftSight heavily parallels AutoCAD, which I think just about every engineer has used at some point. It's very easy to use, especially if you do have 2D CAD experience. You can use command line inputs or any of the great point and click commands that it offers. Another great thing is DraftSight also supports a wide range of 2D CAD file types, including DXFs and DWGs. All right, on to 3D CAD. There's a very cool program called FreeCAD, which has a great range of 3D modeling capabilities, as well as some other common features like detailing, FEA, or FEM, and CAM. Since this is another one of those awesome open source programs, you can also download workbenches for things like sheet metal modeling and even CFD. I'm still pretty new to this program, so I haven't figured out all these features yet, but I definitely plan on getting to know this software better. There are just so many cool things you can do with it. My only real complaint is the workflows and design paradigms aren't the most intuitive. The commercial programs like SolidWorks and Inventor are much easier to use. However, the fact that FreeCAD is, well, free and has such a wide variety of capabilities, it easily makes up for the steeper learning curve. It just takes some getting used to. Now let's take a look at a program called KiCAD. This is one for the electrical and computer engineers out there. KiCAD is an ECAD or EDA software for printed circuit board design. This could be used as an alternative to a program called ECO. It is completely open source, and for not knowing much about PCBs or electronics, I have to say it's pretty easy to use. It has an extensive library of standard electrical components, as well as the ability to design custom components to add to your circuits. You can create circuit schematics, map out your connections, and bring that all together to create a completed PCB design, which can even be viewed in 3D. KiCAD also has features to create bill of materials and Gerber files for the actual manufacturer of the circuit board once you have designed. Let's take a look at some CFD or computational fluid dynamics software. Cornerstone and open source CFD is going to be OpenFOAM, which is a completely open source numerical solver toolbox or library built in C++. This open source library contains solvers and utilities built for simulating or solving various CFD problems. OpenFOAM alone can be used for CFD analysis, but the drawback is that it is all code-based and needs to be executed from a Linux command prompt. Without having a very good understanding of fluid dynamics theory and OpenFOAM and C++ syntax, you'll likely struggle to use this for solving problems. If you do go this route, I recommend you look into a couple other programs to make things a little bit easier, like Gmesh for creating mesh files and Paraview for visualizing the simulation. For people looking for a more intuitive interface like myself, I think SimFlow has one of the best free options. The reason I like SimFlow is that it is desktop-based and offers a pretty intuitive interface, but yet has all the features and options you would need for a variety of simulations at any complexity. The only drawback is the free license limits the number of mesh nodes to 100,000, which can seriously limit the simulation accuracy, especially for more complex analyses. Another thing worth mentioning is there are developers working on creating a CFD toolbox for FreeCAD, which I mentioned earlier, that will use OpenFOAM. This will be available in versions 0.17 and later. It's still in beta testing, but I have had a chance to play around with it and it looks pretty promising. And let's wrap with a couple different options for the programmers out there or those of you looking to learn programming. First, I want to talk about VBA, which stands for Visual Basic for Applications. It is essentially a simplified version of the more powerful and comprehensive Visual Basic. The syntax is the same or similar in many cases, but the difference is that VBA is contained and executed within existing applications. You can think of VBA as a way of automating existing programs like Excel or any of the other Office apps, AutoCAD, or SolidWorks. In my opinion, VBA is one of the best starting points for anyone wanting to learn how to program. I say this because it is not only very easy to understand, but because it is very easy to dive in and start making useful code. Just as a disclaimer, many more advanced or professional programmers might disagree with me on this for a few reasons. One is, since VBA is very simplified and easy to use, it allows for some flexibility and sloppiness in your code and practices. It is not hard to make some code that gets the outcomes you might be looking for, but that doesn't mean that you follow the best coding practices to arrive at that end result. I'm sure that's kind of the case with coding in general, but it's just something that I've noticed in myself as I started to dive into other languages. Now, just to be clear, VBA isn't something you would download or buy or anything like that. As I said, it is contained within any applications in which it is integrated. So it is not technically free, but since most engineers use or at least have access to Office programs like Excel, I include it on the list. For anyone looking for a way to program with more extensive languages and compile custom projects, there's a great open source integrated development environment, or IDE, called Eclipse. An IDE is essentially the workspace to write and compile your code for creating applications, executables, DLLs, etc. Eclipse is very commonly used for Java app development, but has the capability to compile other common languages like C#, C++, PHP, Python, R, the statistical language mentioned earlier, and many more. For engineers, I would recommend Python as a great language to learn. It has very easy to understand syntax, is powerful, and is great for engineering applications. It also has great numerical solver libraries like NumPy for mathematical modeling and data science applications. Hey, you made it to the end. One last thing before you leave, leave me a comment down below and let me know if you plan on adding any of these programs to your engineering toolbox. And also be sure to share this video with all your engineering friends so they can check out these programs as well. And be sure to subscribe so you can get my weekly videos as they're released. Also, I just want to let you know that I really enjoyed making this video. I learned a ton by making it because I didn't know half these programs existed and I've never done anything with like CFD or any of the circuit board design stuff, so that was all great. I learned a ton by making this video, so I really hope you enjoyed it. Also, remember that this channel is for you, so if you have any suggestions for topics you want me to cover, be sure to leave me a comment and let me know that as well. I'd be happy to cover anything or research anything that you guys want to see and kind of break things down into a useful video, hopefully. So make sure to like, share, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.